When we are saying we need humongous space, we need humongous numbers of vaccines. So how much space do those vaccines occupy? Typically, one dose of vaccine is about half an ml, half a milliliter. How much is 1 cubic meter of space? 1 million milliliters. So 1 cubic meter of that vaccine liquid is equivalent to 2 million doses. If it is half an ml per dose, 20 lakh people's dose can come in 1 cubic meter. Now, vaccine will have secondary packaging. There'll be some broken storage. There are WHO standards for space requirements, which is times can be 2 times depending on a vaccine. But let's say it's 3 times. So we need 3 cubic meters of space to store 20 lakh people's worth of vaccine. How much is there much of space in 120-foot container, 120-foot truck, in a reefer truck? It's about 28 meter cubes. So 3 times. So we are saying 1 reefer container can store enough vaccine, about 18 million doses of vaccine. So space is not really an issue. We have to say our reefer containers and our cold storage spaces are designed for, say, between minus 25 to plus 25. So if the vaccine that we are going to adopt for this country comes within that range, Moderna is supposed to be like that, or if it's only 2 to 8, even easier, we have that capacity. Far as logistics movement goes, I'll give you a couple of examples. All of, if 120-foot reefer space can store 18, 19 for calculation's sake, 20 million doses. How many trucks do we need for 130 crore people? It's a simple calculation. We need just about 70 trucks. 70 trucks to move the vaccine for 20 crore people. For the whole world's population, for 500 TEUs, and if you talk about 40 footers, it's half the number, even less than half because the space available is more. If you're going to administer selected groups of people, and that selection is has a geographic spread, which is the subcontinent of India, then we are going to require so many administration centers and so many lots of vaccines moving. So obviously these huge truckloads don't make a difference there. My suggestion, and I've written about it earlier, is that we should do a geographical cluster-based vaccination so that the entire population, 65%, 70% of a population in a geographical cluster is vaccinated and hence cover the entire country as we go along. One, logistics the administering of the vaccine is much more sensible and more evenly planned. Two, more importantly, minute you have everyone vaccinated in a zone, starting, say, from JNK and Ladakh, or starting from somewhere, 3 areas we can start and keep covering until the entire country is covered, the virus is not exposed to the vaccine unnecessarily. If the vaccine is going to be used in minus 20 or 2 to 8, we have no issues. If we're going to start deploying vaccine which requires minus 70, yes, for that carriage, we need to start using dry ice. And that is also possible. But I do not think the basic communication of vaccine in large volumes, because those volumes will never be too much. The whole world can be done in, if it was so perfect, in 400, 500,000 containers. Yeah? But it's about making sure that the piecemeal last mile distribution happens. That also, far as technology and capacities and reefer vehicles is possible, we can divert reefer vehicles from other work for this purpose. Yeah. Mm-hmm. The issue is planning part. Issue is already laying out the ground map of which all are the pin codes, locations within the pin codes, 5 locations each, so that the entire geographical area is vaccinated within 10 days, 15 days, 21 days, if 21 days is the magic number. One person can only vaccinate 120 people. 2 people in one center can do 240 people in a day, in a 10-hour working day. in 21 days, they will have finished off 5,000 people. Now that's a nice number, because if you realize 85% of our villages are population 5,000 or less. If you see Delhi, it is broken up into these colonies, which are around 5,000 on average here. So the important part is how many people do we have to give vaccine? The other aspect, and it's part of logistics. Administration is going to be part of the logistics process. There is not so much base volume requirements, but there will be volumes from point of reception to point of delivery, where volumes will be very small. And if you have to fight this virus, you shouldn't be worried so much about that. I mean, you can sit in your car and take it, you know, take a box with the cool stuff. Of course, there's the opportunity for supply chain planners to start thinking how, even if it is a 20-foot truckload, Delhi ke liye theek hai, two truckloads does the job for all of Delhi. But suppose you have to go somewhere, population only 1 million or 5 million or something. Then that you can start off with one truckload from the vaccine manufacturers and do a piecemeal drop-off. Drop off so many boxes here, drop off so many boxes here. It's called a milk run. We do it with the milk system. We do it with fruit and vegetables here. So I don't think domain experts would be too worried about that. The worry is what temperatures do we need those spaces for? And of course, the worry is on the administration side. The team which is planning on how many centers to vaccinate, where all to go, should we do it all together in one place and move along, or should we do a few people everywhere to start off with?